favor, and their bench outscored our bench by 2. But Coach Nibert is here, and Coach, the start of the ball game was not obviously the start that we wanted.
No.
I think their zone really causes some problems in the first half. I know that we did not seem to get into the flow of the game as quickly as I know you would have liked to. But I tell you what, in the second half, this team down 16 points went on an 18-2 run to really show what they're made of and came back and actually took the lead in this game.
Yeah, that was what I was, most proud of. I mean, we had a tough loss there on Thursday, and I think we were still reeling a little bit from that. Plus, we changed the lineup a little bit and put Josh Clyburn there, who did a, great job getting 10 rebounds and really did some really good things out there. So, that's really the first kind of day we did that. I saw some awfully good things. I'm disappointed that we lost, and I think what hurt us was, we got down 10 the first half, but really what hurt us was the beginning of the second half, where we had about, two or three turnovers and fumbled the ball, and they kind of came after us and made it 16 points real fast, 16, 18 points real fast there, I think, or at least 16. Mm-hmm. And then you got to battle back. But, then we proved how we could play and our potential there, of all the good things in there that went on in that 18, as you said, 18-2 run to take the lead. And that's what we've got to take out of this game. What are the good things that we did, in that game that brought us that lead? Because I think it was a two-point game with 3 minutes to go. Mm-hmm. And we battled back in there, and unfortunately they made the plays, and we didn't make the plays there at the end. And the score is definitely not indicative of the last 10 minutes of the game.
That's right. And these guys, this Campbell team, decided early on they were going to pack that zone back and really try to keep the ball out of Zoe Coleman's hand. And they were able to do that in the first half. We did a better job of getting him involved in the offense in the second half, and that made a big difference.
Well, it did. And he had 2 fouls in the first half, so we had to get him out of there. So we had to play with somebody else. But like I said, we're down 10, but we were – really towards the end there, we were in there pretty good, other than the start, like you said. But he gets 13 points and made some nice plays down in there. And like I said, I couldn't have been prouder of especially Josh, Josh Clyburn's play and his rebounding. He's going to do nothing but get better and better, we didn't shoot the ball well. Khalid is really, he's struggling a little bit and pressing. But we know he's a good shooter. We probably need to look to try to drive the ball a little bit there, but I know he's giving his heart and soul out there because he's playing 40 minutes, and we got to get him a break in there.
Yeah, leading the league and leading your conference in minutes played, of course, and he plays all of the night. He is a warrior out there, and I tell you, Pierre Miller, with a heart as big as this building, and he knocks down 4 three-pointers out there for you tonight, and really carried you there for a little while in the comeback.
Well, he sure did. He made some big plays out there, and really proud of him and his shooting. He's 4 for 6. We got to get him again some more shots, as we did there early, and really proud of Eric Washington coming in there. I had 7 assists and really did some really good things. And Jay Reynolds came in there for 11 minutes, and I thought his play on Eric Griffin was really good, and that was a key matchup. Josh did a great job on him, and we just got to keep going to work. We got, we've had 5 games in 11 days, dating back to Army on that Wednesday, December 28th, and we've moved some things around, we've changed some things around, and we really haven't had a chance to, practice a whole lot, because we've been really trying to get ready, for the next team, and I think we found something with a good, starting 5, and I think we found something with guys coming off the bench, and hopefully we can do nothing but get better and better. And we've got Charleston Southern next Thursday, and we got Coastal next Saturday, and we just got to keep our heads up and keep going.
We got Charleston Southern on the road and Coastal on the road, and in between those two again, we have UNC Asheville, and then we get those guys in here to our place. So you just got to you got to go get tough and go on the road and get a couple of wins and come back into the Templeton Center for 3 straight. Coming up later this month. But, Coach, thank you for joining us.
Appreciate it, Rhett.
Best of luck to you as you go forward onto the road, and let's get a couple of wins down there.
All right. Thanks a lot, buddy.
Okay, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Coach Greg Nibert, as we end this Matt Davis State Farm postgame show, final score here from the Templeton Center, Campbell 77, Presbyterian 65. I'd like to thank John Robert Avery back at the station for all his help, for everybody here that got us coached up, everybody that helps out here along the Presbyterian.